ಬೆಂಬಾಗಿರದು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ತಿಳಿವಿಗೆ ತೊಡಕು ತೋರದಿ ಹೋದ.
ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ, ಡಿಗ್ನಿಟರೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಡಯಸ್, ದ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಎ ಎಂ ಖಾನ್, ದ ಇನಾಗರೇಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್, ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲಿಕಟ್, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನಿರ್ಮಲ್ ಬಾಬು, ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕಲ್ಟಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಫ್ಯಾಕಲ್ಟಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಅಫಿಲಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಕಾಲೇಜಸ್, ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಅಟ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಸೆಟ್ ಐ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಇನಾಗರಲ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ 3-day ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕಲಿ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಟ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ಯೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸಸ್. ದ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎ ಡೆಕೇಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಆರ್ಗನೈಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಮೋಟಿವೇಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎ ಡೆಕೇಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ನೋಟಿಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್, ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ಬಯಾಲಜಿ ಅಟ್ ದ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಟ್ ದ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡ್ರಾಸ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ದ ರೀಸನ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬಬ್ಲಿ ನಾಟ್ ನೋನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವೈ ದೆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಡ್ರಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಸೀಕರ್ಸ್, ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್, ನೈದರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ students as such nor for the society as a whole. Government gave a serious thought to it and decided to attract the students for the basic sciences and any country for that matter to progress, to achieve a good progress, the country should have the basics of science, basics of particularly the fundamental sciences. Only if the basics of fundamental science is good, the fundamental is good, then you can think of all other developmental activities. Keeping this in mind, the government has decided through the Department of Science and Technology, Government of Karnataka, to organize the program of this kind. And there is a wing under Department of Science and Technology at the government level, Government of Karnataka level, that is called Karnataka Science and Technology Academy. That's what you can see in the banner itself. Karnataka Science and Technology Academy is a wing of the Science and Technology Division of the state government. So Karnataka Science and Technology Academy has got a body, governing body, with a president. The Professor U.R. Rao is the president of Academy, Karnataka Science and Technology Academy, and the activities are being monitored by an executive director, Dr. H. Honnegowda. And there is a governing council with the stalwarts, those who have contributed immensely in different fields of basic sciences, The Karnataka Science and Technology Academy has designed to organize the courses of 3 days or the lecture series of 3 days to motivate, to attract towards the basic sciences the young talented minds. With this background, the lecture series trend was initiated. As I said, the students opting for basic sciences has been reduced over the years. In order to overcome and attract the students to the basic sciences, this program was initiated. And particularly to induce the students to take up basic sciences courses. Otherwise, the trend used to be immediately after 10th, take up science mostly and then try for engineering, medicine and all the professional courses. If nothing is available or you are not able to get, then ultimately you end up with joining BSc. And once again, in BSc, if there is a technical course, you would opt for that, but only when nothing is available. Very few students, with exceptions, all of them were forced to take up basic sciences only because others were not available. Because students were not motivated nor attracted towards the basic sciences as such. So, in order to overcome all those drawbacks of the student level or limitations of the student level, the lecture series of this kind was initiated. To let the students to know about what is happening in the basic sciences and why the studies in basic sciences is important. And any person who has got the sound knowledge in basic sciences will definitely be able to think better in terms of technology. Today's basic science is said to be tomorrow's technology. Unless you know something about science, basic science, you may not be able to do much of the things or better in the technology. That's why the word science and technology always goes hand in hand. We normally don't say technology and science, we always say science and technology. If you know the science, the technology automatically will find its place. You will be able to achieve excellence in technology. So, to do something in technology or engineering, you need to know or you need to have a sound background of basic subjects. Maybe it is physics or chemistry or mathematics or biology. So, to achieve this, the science and technology mission has initiated the lecture series, and this lecture series is being organized by me with the sponsorship of Karnataka Science and Technology Academy for 3 days in different disciplines such as physics, chemistry, botany, zoology, maths, agriculture, medicine. And now this year the science and technology KSTA has introduced the one program on technology also. This year 4 courses of this kind is being organized in the Karnataka state. One is this program in Botanical Sciences, Mangalore University. Another one is Biotechnology. It is coincidence that the Biotechnology program, 3-day lecture series of under Biotechnology subject, he is being inaugurated by our own Vice Chancellor, Professor K. Bhairappa at Gulbarga. Today is the same time, it is also being inaugurated in Gulbarga University on Biotechnology. And another program is being organized by Bangalore University on Geoinformatics, and yet another program is on Chemistry at Karnataka University. As I said, the basic objectives of this lecture series is that the students to let the students to know about contemporary aspects and current research going on in the fields of basic sciences, and to motivate the students to take up higher education in basic sciences. And the research that is being carried out in the institutes of national and international repute should be also made known to the students by inviting the speakers from the institutes of national and international repute. Much more than that, it is not just learning or understanding the basic sciences. With the knowledge that you gain after or while doing your program in basic sciences, you should also be able to understand and analyze knowledge that you have gained, and ultimately, you should be able to apply your knowledge in the field of your own interest. That is, the possibility of looking at the self-employment. Self-employment. The knowledge that you have gained should help you to get a job. If you are not able to get a job, you should be able to find a job suitable to you. You should be able to generate a job for yourself. That is actually the motto behind the organizing this lecture. And more than that, the recent aspects like biotechnology, nanotechnology and such other technologies should be exposed to the students of basic sciences, so that you develop the interest and you will take up the research in the due course on these aspects. With this intention, the 3-day lecture series called Science Special Lecture Series is being organized with the sponsorship of Karnataka State Science and Technology Division, Karnataka Science and Technology Academy under the Karnataka Science and Technology Ministry, by Mangalore University, the Department of Applied Botany. I welcome all of you this 3 days lecture series at the outset. For this program, I will give the further details of the program later on. For this program, we were in fact thinking of inviting a person to inaugurate the program, and immediately the name of Dr. K. Nirmal Babu strike our mind. Dr. Nirmal Babu has been a good friend of Mangalore University in general and the Department of Applied Botany in particular. His association with the department is more than 2 decades now. And Dr. Nirmal Babu, when we requested Dr. Nirmal Babu to come over here and to inaugurate the program, he said, "I wish to do that, but unfortunately I may not be able to do so because I have got a meeting very next day at Thiruvananthapuram." He has been summoned by the DG and also the Minister of State Government, Kerala, to have a meeting with them, what we call high level committee meeting tomorrow, and he said it may be difficult. Then he only came out with a solution that I'll come to Mangalore, I'll go to Thiruvananthapuram directly, and he had to change all his itinerary and made his presence possible today with us. I extend a very hearty welcome on behalf of all of us to you, sir. You made it and we are very happy and we enjoy your presence. Thank you very much, sir. Professor K. Bhairappa was supposed to inaugurate this program. Unfortunately, his program was scheduled somewhere else and he requested the registrar to inaugurate the program. But unfortunately, the registrar also stuck up with some other program and he requested the registrar evaluation, and I also approached the registrar evaluation at the nth moment with little of hesitation, because when you invite a person to preside over the function at the nth moment, mostly the people will be busy, and particularly the people like Dr. Khan. Professor A.M. Khan is also working as the registrar evaluation, and his schedule is very busy that the examinations are going on. He is supposed to be there by 9 o'clock at his office, and the colleges will open the question paper and he should be ready with his computer, internet, mobile, everything. Any moment anything might happen and Dr. Khan should be able to answer all those things. And he made some alternate arrangement and he agreed that I'll come because it is Department of Applied Botany and I love to come, he said, and he is there with us. On behalf of all of us, I extend a hearty, warm welcome to Professor A.M. Khan. We have with us the faculty members from other departments, Alwas College, Chikalwara. I welcome all of you, sir. I extend a very warm welcome to all my students, whether you are from our institution, from Applied Botany Department, for Biosciences Department, or Botany Department of Alwas College, or from Chikalwar. All of you are considered to be our students, and I welcome all of you to this program. I welcome the people from electronic media and communication, because whatever that we discuss, ultimately the message should go to the public. Why the 3 days lecture series is important. Why the basic science is needed for the development of the country. And these aspects will be highlighted only through the media, and media people have positively responded to our invitation, and I extend a very warm welcome to all the media friends. I welcome all of you once again to this program, and I wish all of you will be enjoying the program and go contented after 3 days of series of lectures from the eminent people. I would like to give a brief about the lectures and the programs which is going to be there for the next 3 days. There will be a lecture by genetic mint by Dr. K. Nirmal Babu, followed by the inauguration on genetic and genomic resources of spices, followed by a lecture by K.G. Bhatt, Professor K.G. Bhatt, on plant diversity of Western Ghats with special reference to Karnataka, and palm genetic resources, diversity, conservation and utilization by Dr. Anita Karun, emergent trends in drug discovery, prospects of natural sources by Dr. Jagan from Vidya Herbs Private Limited, Bangalore. Use of plants in drug industry, he will be speaking on that, and biology of parasitic angiosperms, the gold mines of botanical curiosities by Professor G.R. Shivamurthy from Mysore, and another topic on development in nutraceuticals, botanicals and functional foods. Mostly he will be speaking on use of plants as nutraceuticals or functional foods, etc., by once again a person from Vidya Herbs, Bangalore. And naming of the plants by Professor G.R. Shivamurthy. And on the last day, we have a lecture by once again a private industry person, Dr. Varanasi Krishnamurthy, on biofertilizers. You need not search for a job, you can generate a job for yourself. And another topic on mangroves by Dr. Hegde, and one more topic by Dr. Santosh J. Ethan, probably on the recent techniques being used in science general, in botanical science in general and pathological sciences in particular. I think he will be speaking mostly on advanced techniques and technologies. These are the aspects which are going to be covered in the next 3 days, and I am sure you will be enjoying these 3 days program. I have another pleasant task to perform, to introduce Dr. K. Nirmal Babu. When I asked his biodata, he said there is no need to introduce me as a speaker. He is a very simple person, very sincere, committed scientist who had served initially in CPCRI Vittal, and then he has transferred to IISR Calicut, and recently he has taken up as the director of Indian Institute of Spice Research at Calicut. He is also coordinating a All India coordinated project on spices, right? All India coordinated research project on spices. That is, I think probably he will be able to explain in detail about how many institutes he will be controlling through his All India coordinated research project. Dr. K. Nirmal Babu is presently director, Indian Institute of Spices Research, which is under Indian Council of Agriculture Research. He is also the national coordinator of spices. When I asked his biodata, he has given only the two lines. These two lines he has given. I think much of the aspects related to Professor Nirmal Babu you will come to know through his lecture which he is going to present after the inaugural address. With this very brief introduction, I once again welcome Dr. K. Nirmal Babu as an inaugurator to this program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I request the convener of this program, Professor Chandrasekhar, to welcome our chief guest, the director, Dr. K. Nirmal Babu, the Spice Research Center, Calicut, Kerala, with a flower bouquet. I also request Professor Krishna Kumar to welcome our Register of Evaluations, Professor A. Khan, with a flower bouquet. Thank you, sir. Now I request our Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. K. Nirmal Babu, to inaugurate the function by lighting the lamp. I request all the dignitaries to join with him. Purity, a light symbolizes wisdom, and a light symbolizes knowledge. I would like to thank the Goddess of the Knowledge for blessing us. I also request Professor Tara. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Now the much awaited talk, I request our chief guest to address the inaugural gathering.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Respected Professor A.M. Khan, Registrar Evaluation, the president of today's function, and my good friends, and maybe in some level guides, Professor K.R. Chandrasekhar and Professor Krishna Kumar. We had depended upon them for so many things. The staff of the Applied Botany Department and also the allied departments from this university and otherwise, and of course you, ladies and gentlemen, mostly ladies, who has to take care of this lamp of botanical sciences forward. Welcome into the special lecture series on botanical sciences. As I told you, all of us know, why do we study botany? Because it is fundamental for life. That group of organisms which we call part of botany has a very special character. What is the difference between plants and animals? You know, we all will argue whether I should study zoology or botany. Okay. So if you say that all animals are not there, plants survive. If all plants are not there, no animal will survive. That is the character. The character to convert solar or any energy into substances which keeps our life sustained. It's not a character to be taken very lightly. That's why we study botany. Until we develop by which all animals can also synthesize the requirements from the far away. You know, in Calicut there is a person, a Jain professor, who doesn't eat food at all. it takes absorbs energy from solar energy morning. You can see in Google, and maybe I'll be able to present a few things into insights of how the process happens and what we should do. But at this point of time, without plants we don't have oxygen, we don't have clean water, we don't have environment, and more than anything else we don't have our next tea or coffee or lunch, without which we our shape will change by tomorrow. The food is not given. And by third day, you can't even recognize yourself. That's the power. We are students of that power. And with the latest technologies and your imagination and intelligence, you can change it any way you like. Tomorrow, if we have to, we are going to Mars, we are going to this, what for? If you want to do future colonization, you must know botany, without which it is simply not possible. So just to say that this particular point to each one of you, that without that group who call botanical specimens, we will not survive. Life will not survive. And we are students of that particular process. As we see in the next 3 days, different people will be telling what should be done, what should not be done, and you, all of you already know. But keep this in mind. This is the power we want to. Why do you study science? So that we have power over elements. Okay, not simply just A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. It's for that. And the power we want to gain is understand plants, how do they convert, why others are not able to do it. And if you are able to do it, and you know it's better than any science anywhere in the world. I think this much will do for an inaugural address. Be proud, because you are trying to study so that in future we control the process of photosynthesis. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your inaugural address. I request the Register of Evaluation of our University, Mangalore University, Professor A.M. Khan, to give the President's remarks.
Good morning to all of you. Respected Chief Guest of the inaugural program of 3-day lecture series on recent trends in botanical sciences being held at Mangalore University in association with Karnataka Science and Technology Academy, Government of Karnataka, the chairman of the department and the convener of this lecture series, Professor K.R. Chandrasekhar, my friends in Department of Applied Botany, Professor Krishna Kumar, Dr. Raju, faculty members from other departments, media friends, students, ladies and gentlemen. It gives an immense pleasure to be among people who are talking of power and life. I am closely attached with the Department of Applied Botany, having had good friends there and working with Professor Chandrasekhar in various committees for a long time now. Moreover, the title that is there, that is Recent Trends in Botanical Sciences, matches with what we usually have in Engineering Sciences. I belong to electronics, where we always talk of trends in electronics, where trends keep changing, the devices keep changing, the circuits keep changing. Similarly, I thought it would be a nice occasion to listen to speakers. I was expecting Dr. Nirmal Babu to give me more insights on what were the trends in his inaugural address. However, I'll attend this lecture later on and find out more, because in the morning when we were discussing in the guest house, I got so many insights from him. In the inaugural address, he has rightly pointed out that botanical sciences are important. That is the power, they give energy, they give life. Life depends on botanical sciences. He used the term no life without botanical sciences. It's rightly said. And he also told the definition of the process, botanical sciences, the process as a whole, which makes us understand the phenomena and know the engineering behind what is happening in this whole process of giving power or giving life to whatever organisms or human beings we are here. The objective of lecture series by KSTA has been very well defined by Professor K.R. Chandrasekhar. He stressed on one aspect of entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is an important aspect, how you can employ yourself rather than being employed by others. An important topic, and I was told that there is going to be a speaker who will speak on that aspect also. Having known the title, I was just thinking of recent trends in botanical sciences. The trends should speak on the positive aspects as well as the negative aspects. Positive aspects are very well known. It all depends on agriculture, the quality of agriculture that we have, the engineering that is being used, the technology that is being used in agriculture. How can we improve upon the quality of the product? How can we improve upon the quantity of the product with less labor? All these also will be trends which help in understanding how positively we can grow, how agriculture can grow, how botanical sciences can help in growth of agriculture, thereby the growth of the country, because India is largely dependent on agriculture for its income. At the same time, there are negative trends also, which as students of botany, one should know. Negative trends like, say, money, market. Because of market, there is a lot of adulteration. Anything is mixed. Okay, now we find green peas which are more green in color. They are more colored than actually being green in color. Then in the morning, in the guest house, our chief guest was telling how turmeric powder is adulterated with lead. Lead is said to be so poisonous. But still, it is being adulterated with a compound of lead, which has an effect on us. Then why does not cancer increase when intake of lead is increasing? So I had a doubt. I was afraid when he told this aspect. And how agricultural products are helping the other market. Okay, how middlemen are capturing the market. That also, Professor Chandrasekhar told you how you can employ, instead of depending on multinational companies, how you yourself can have, or you yourself can produce fertilizers, etc. So all these negative aspects also should be known. So as students of botany, you should know what are the trends that are going on, both on the growth side as well as on the side that is bringing down the quality, the quantity, and have a doubt on the produce itself. So I think in the next 3 days, we have very good speakers, very good topics, right from genetics to the plants to the fertilizers. Okay, and so many nice speakers will be there. I hope we'll have a good time with them. One aspect I would like to tell each one of you, please feel free to ask questions. All the experts will be here. Don't hesitate to ask any questions. Okay, the present trend of students, when I go for industrial placement of my students, the feedback that I get from the industries is, your students are very good, but they don't speak. Have the habit of speaking, my dear friends. Ask questions. Let it be a silly question also, don't worry. Question is a question. You have to raise your hand, ask a question, get your doubts clarified. Maybe that small silly question lead to another question which is very important, we don't know. So please feel free, ask questions, get your doubts cleared, get more knowledge from this, and try to utilize that knowledge in helping the growth of botanical sciences. Thank you for a patient hearing. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. It's a pride and a honor for me to give a word of thanks today. Respected dignitaries and dais and of the dais, chairpersons of all the departments, various departments, students of different departments. For this inauguration of 3 days lecture series, we are so fortunate to have Director Dr. K. Nirmal Babu, Calicut Spice Calicut, Kerala, as a chief guest, and I personally, on behalf of Mangalore University and the Department of Applied Botany, I'm grateful to you, sir, for inaugurating this program. Honorable Register, evaluations, was responsible for all the administrative support for these programs, and we are so grateful to you, sir, for presiding over these functions and giving the presidential remarks. Thank you, sir. We have with us chairpersons and faculty members of different departments of our university. I thank them for responding to our invitations by participating in this program. I would like to thank KSTA for financial support, and we are gratefully acknowledged. We are very much thankful to our engineering department for arrangement made in this auditorium for the program. I am immensely happy to place a record of our gratitude to our chairperson, convener of this program, Professor Chandrasekhar, for his effort in planning and organizing this program. My sincere thanks to all the media, print and electronic media, and our own university photographer, Chandrasekhar, and Nitesh for covering this program. Lastly, I would like to thank all my colleagues, staff, non-teaching staff, research scholars, master students of the different departments for their favorable support in organizing this program. Now, we have a tea break for the 15 minutes, and we'll come back after 15 minutes. Thank you.